strong tower makes me safe.
Familiar scripture that is always quoted. When Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Good morning. Our lesson title today is just that: Wisdom, the Way, the Truth, and the Life. We're going to be in John chapter 14, verses 1 through 14 today for our focus. We have a few more for the lesson to give you a little more background on wisdom. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 17, and Proverbs chapter 8, verse 32 through 36. Read those in your leisure time. So today we're in chapter 14, John chapter 14. We're talking about wisdom, the way, the truth, and the life. So chapter 14, where we are. Painting the picture, giving you the visual, giving you the historical context. Jesus is basically, he's saying his final goodbyes. He's told them in John chapter 13 of his departure. And now when we see chapter 14, the disciples, they're hurt. Let's just be real about it. They're hurt. The person that they come to know, the person that they've come to love, the person that they've come to most of all respect and admire, has told them that he's leaving. He not say he's just leaving and he not will be with them. He says, I got something else to do. Jesus said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. Because in my Father's house there are many mansions, so I got to go fix some stuff up for you. I got to go prepare a place for you. And even when he said that, all the things that he'd done, what led to I am the way, the truth, the life, Thomas said, Lord, we do not know where you're going. How can we know the way? And Jesus answered by saying, I am the way, the truth, and the life. That's how you know where to go. You follow Jesus. That's how you know where he's going, when you're following him, when you're constantly after him. And the disciples, they continued to ask him. Philip even asked him. And Jesus, you know, he kept answering them and answering them. And he was giving them scenarios. Jesus also said, he said, believe, in verse 11, he says, believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. But if you don't believe that, believe because of the works themselves. The works that Jesus had done through the power of the Father. If you don't believe that is in me, just believe that. That should be reason enough to believe it. In verse 13, Jesus also said, I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If in my name you ask me for anything, I will do. So, let's just look at what Jesus is saying in chapter 14. He said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. I got to leave, but I'm finna go do some work for y'all. And while I'm up there working, by the way, if you need anything, just ask in my name, and I got you. It'll be taken care of. So he's going to build for us. He's going to prepare places for us. So that he's going to do a lot. That's a lot to do for every Christian, every person that proclaims. People are still proclaiming and confessing that Jesus Christ, people are still accepting Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior to this day. So what does that mean? Jesus is still up there building. He's building. And he's still whatever we need. So Jesus is a busy person. He's up there working for us. He's not saying, look, I got to go up here and build. Don't y'all bother me. I got to go up here and get this stuff ready. If y'all want it done right, leave me alone. Because too often in life, when we get busy with things, we say, look, I'm busy. I got to take care of this. Don't bother me. If you need something, go to your mama. If you need something, go to your daddy. If you need this, go to this person. If you need this, go to that person. I'm too busy to take care of this for you. But Jesus said, no, I'm going to build. I'm going to take care of some things for you. But oh, by the way, if you need anything while I'm gone, before I come back, just ask in my name, and I will take care of it for you. What a great example of living. What a great example of Christianity. What a great example of a great leader. What a great example for men, for women to follow today. Because he didn't leave us alone. Now, some points I want to take home today. Usually I don't pick my book up, but today I'm going to do it because I had to jot some things down that God gave me. And I wanted to make sure I hit it. Point one, Jesus was saying that this part of his mission was coming to an end. He said, I must go from you to get things ready for you, but I will work for you when you ask. So we already went over that there. He's going to do some building, but I still got you. I'm going to be even busier, but I got you. I still got you. My brothers and my sisters, I still got you. Anything you need from the Father, ask in Big Brother's name, I got you. So, Jesus laid it all out there for them. It saddened them. Why did it sadden them? So why? If Jesus was telling them, I'm going to prepare a place for you, but I'm not going to be too busy up there that I can't help you. Why? You have to realize Jesus was a supreme leader. Jesus was their Lord. He was the foretold one. Those who believe in Jesus, they knew that Jesus was the prophecy being fulfilled. So, why? Why would he leave them when it felt that things were so great? So that disturbed them. When his following was hype, when Jesus was doing great things, and he said, I gotta leave. I gotta go. I got some more work to do. This part of me. So it perplexed them. It messed their heads up. So what they had to realize is Jesus had spent this time, next one, Jesus had built them up on earth so that they may build up others on earth. And all this was possible when they asked in his name so that God would be glorified. So Jesus was spending that time. So they thought, and Jesus would come in to lead them and to show them and fulfill the prophecy and fulfill everything about the law. But Jesus was also building them up. He was building them up so that they may be leaders, so that they may go out and do these things. So all this time, they had got caught up. Now, don't get me wrong. Now, these men, they were good men. The disciples, the followers, they were good men. But they had become engulfed, and they become so relaxed, for a better word, for a slight terminology. They were just great. Things were good. They had a good leader. They were following Jesus. Even when the naysayers would come up to them and try to trip Jesus up, the way that Jesus would handle them with the word and wouldn't let it faze them, the way he took things down, the way he took people down, it was just astonishing in them. So they were saying, why you gotta go? Why you gotta leave us? Because he had been building them up so that they may build others up. And that's what we have to do. When Jesus has built us up, when Jesus had done a great work in us, we have to go build somebody else up. And then they go build somebody else up. See, at this time, Jesus had built them up. So it was time for them to be the visual representation of God. See, Jesus was that representation. Jesus was God. He was that for them. So it was time for them to be that for someone else. They were now to be the visual representation of God. They were to use the wisdom and the knowledge Jesus had gave and taught them to do so. So it was their time. It was their time. So Jesus had done that in them. It was their time to do this. They thought they weren't ready. That's why they were sad. They thought they weren't ready. So often in our lives, we think we're not ready. When Jesus has called for us to do something, we think we're not ready. When Jesus has assigned us, see, we think all the time when Jesus has an assignment for us, he tells us directly. But sometimes Jesus will move somebody else out of the way because it is our time to step up. So sometimes leaders have to get out of the way. Next one. Sometimes leaders have to get out of the way for someone else to step up. Sometimes leaders see that the people behind them and the people under them, they're, for lack of a better word, they're so dependent on them that their growth is stunted. Their growth has become stunted because they're saying, as long as that leader said, as long as I'm here, you won't take that next step. So I got to get out of the way. I got to get out of the way so that you may rise up, so that you may lead. Jesus had to get out of the way. He had better works to do. But sometimes leaders, they have to get out of the way so that you may step up. Jesus had to get out of the way so the disciples could step up. He had to go and do greater works. But the works here, the works on earth, still need to be done. They still needed to be done. So Jesus left that with them. So often, we're up under good teachings. We have life lessons. So I say that the good teachings that we're getting, if you find yourself, if you're under a great pastor, if you're under a great leader right now in your Christian journey, your mentor, whoever he or she may be, don't let the good teachings, don't let the good lessons go to waste. Because, my brothers and sisters, there will come a time when that person has to go. Whether it's they go from this earth through death or whether they have a different assignment on this earth, they are going to leave one day. And it's going to be your time to step up. Just as it was the disciples' time to step up, it will be your time to step up. And you step up. You step up, and when you step up, you lead. You lead like Christ led, because he is the way, he is the truth, he is the life. So you follow him. If you're disturbed, if you don't know where to go, you ask him. If that fear tries to, that comes into you and say you're not ready, you talk to Christ. Yeah, the song says, yeah, have a little talk with Jesus. You tell him all about your troubles. Have a little talk with him. When it's time for you to step up and you think you're not ready, have a little talk with Jesus. And you tell him all about it. And Jesus, he got you. Even though he's up there busy building mansions for us in heaven, even though he's building, even though he's working hard, even though he has a full-time job and he's on it 24/7, he's still gonna help us out. He's still gonna say, "Daddy, you hear? Daddy, they need you. Daddy." Johnny asking about you. Daddy, Vincent asking. Vincent needs some help. Daddy, Pat asking. Daddy, Lucia asking. Daddy, John. Daddy, this person. He's boom, boom. He's putting stuff up. He's putting roofs on the mansions. He said, "Daddy, they need you. What you need? I got you." And we have to be the same way. When you're so deep in your computers, and you're so deep in your work, and your child says, "Hey, look at this." Don't say, "I'm busy." Say, "What you got, baby? What you got, son? What you got, daughter?" That lifts them up. When you're so busy doing the things, doing things, and somebody said, hey, I need your help. What you need, brother? What you need, sister? Don't get so consumed. Because Jesus is very consumed right now. Not only is he building, not only is he helping us, but he's doing a supreme job of advocating for us. Because that old Satan, he's saying, look at them, they getting it wrong. Look at them, they getting it wrong. What you gonna do, God? And Jesus is saying, I paid for that. I took care of that. I got this. When they hit me right here, and that blood that was shed on Calvary's cross, it's still good. It still works. It still has its power. Sit down, Satan. So that's why you said, in the name of Jesus, I pray. In the name of Jesus, you ask it, you shall receive it. We will be able to do great works. In Jesus' name, my brothers and sisters. Jesus has taught us. He's left us with the wisdom. Use it. Help somebody else out. Work on it. He's busy, but he got us. We can be busy, but we can still have somebody else's back too. Have a great day. Be blessed. Stay safe. I love you.